I'm Barbara Dixon, and this is Anna Belcher, and we're with Southern Bancorp Bank. Southern is a different kind of bank. We are a designated community development financial institution, and our main focus, our mission, is to be involved in and serve the community. And what makes us different is we offer traditional banking services, but we also offer other services that help strengthen our community, to teach them financial literacy and to help them to build credit, understand credit, and to make good, wise choices. Some of the programs we offer, we have a learning center that covers everything from savings to loans to small business, housing. There's also a section of that website that is designated for youth that's broken up by age groups, so you can get financial literacy information for your children on that website. There's a section for senior citizens as well. We also offer free credit review. We will help you pull your free credit report, go over it with you, give you the resources to review it and to know what to look for. We offer a credit builder CD loan to help you start building credit history or to improve your credit history. We also offer free counseling services, whether you want to just do a budget or just ask questions. That service is free, and it's all free to customers and non-customers alike. We offer free home ownership counseling services. We offer free income tax preparation through the VITA program. It's a voluntary income tax preparation assistance program. And for consumers who qualify, we prepare their taxes free. We will be doing that right here in the Larkspur branch. A lot of what Southern does is they try to strengthen the community, the businesses and individuals alike. And we are considered, one of our models is to be wealth builders for everyone. And one of the primary ways we start that is by teaching savings habits. And Anna is going to tell you a little bit about some of those.
We have a few savings products that's going on right now. One is our Roundup Savings. Every time you use your debit card, you can either round up to the next dollar amount, or you can round up a certain dollar, whether it's one or five, just whatever is convenient for you. And we also have what is called an app that you can download, and the app is called Envy. And it is a savings game. It's 100 days process, and you determine how much you want to save in 100 days. And every day that you go into the app, you open the envelope, and it may transfer a dollar, it may transfer $2. Whatever is in that envelope on that app that day is how much it transferred to your savings account. We also have what we call a CD credit builder loan. If you are just starting out and getting credit, or you've just graduated from school and you're having a hard time getting credit because you have no credit score, or even if you've had past negative credit, then you can come in and we can start you out with credit of a CD loan, and that also gives you a CD. When you pay your loan off, that CD is your money. And Southern believes in Sevier County. We believe in empowering our community, and we are thankful to be here in Sevier County, and we look forward to serving Sevier County and the people in this community for years to come.
Welcome to the 2024 Arkansas High Razorback National Signing Day.
You signed that?
My name is Trey Outlaw, and I'm the athletic director here. It is a great day to be a Razorback. It's also a great day to be a Reddy, a Boll Weevil, a Sugar Bear, a Mule Rider, a Colt, and a Cowboy. We want to start off by thanking Dr. Kessler and Mr. Taylor, our superintendent and assistant superintendent, for making athletics a priority at Arkansas High. Athletics is not everything in education, but it is the front porch. It's the first thing people see when they visit your school. From our facilities to the success that we have on the playing field, athletics is an avenue for our young people to gain life skills that are important to your future. These lessons that they learn, they're very valuable. They teach them how to be successful fathers, wives, husbands, mothers, Most importantly, it teaches them how to be successful citizens. It teaches them whenever things in life get going and it's hard, they learn how to overcome. They learn how to have great character. They learn how to persevere. They learn what it takes to be successful. All of these things are learned at Arkansas High through the Avenue of Athletics. Arkansas High is also a place that dreams come true. Today we have 9 Razorbacks that get to see their dreams come true. They have shown that Arkansas High is a place where the possibilities are endless. It's a place where you don't need to cross the state line or go to another school to be able to further your education or play at the next level. Through all of their hard work, their tremendous academic success, they have laid a pathway for their teammates to look at them and look at the future and what it can hold. So we are forever thankful for these young men and young women on showing that the possibilities at A-High are endless. Again, it's a great day to be a Razorback. I'd like to introduce Mr. Taylor, Assistant Superintendent, to come and say a couple words of encouragement to our guys. Thank you.
And listen, this is an exciting day for Arkansas High School, for Texarkana Arkansas School District, because not only are we showcasing student athletes, but we're also showcasing what Arkansas High has become. It has become a breeding ground for colleges and universities to come and see that there's great talent here at Arkansas High School. And so what these young individuals have done today, they're bridging the gap. You all that are sitting in the stands, one day you all too will strive to be sitting where they are sitting here today. I want to congratulate them. I want to congratulate their parents. I want to congratulate their parents, grandparents, and their families. But also want to congratulate the coaches. The coaches have done a tremendous job, especially starting with Coach Trey Outlaw, to make sure that these students get the recognition that they deserve and become the young leaders of the future. So I want to say congratulations and thank you for being here, and congratulations to all of our honorees on today. Thank you. Mr. Tim Elon, the track coach.
Thank you, Mr. Taylor. This is going to be a first for us, because I have to say that club standing has always been considered a club. We're not part of sports curriculum. And Aubrey is sitting to him by herself whenever she is going to be the first student that we have ever had since 2009 to stand for college. So how about there's a plus in itself. She's biking them out, and we have to follow out from that. She started with us in the 6th grade, so she's been shooting with us for 7 years. She's consistently always placed a high average amongst her peers, and she's always placed on state level teams almost every season she's competed. She's highly motivated, driven to succeed, and always looking to get ahead of everybody else for lack of a better time. She has chosen to sign a Constantine coach, and Coach Brent Blackman over here. And we hope for her to have many more years of success after that. And I'm going to turn this over to Miss Christy Wade. That's all I have to say for now.
Good morning, everybody. Again, we're here this morning. This is our first signing of the 2024-2025 academic year, and we are here with Miss Aubrey. And she's going to be shooting with us next year, coming next fall, and we're looking forward to it. We're going to be real excited about having Aubrey come on board and be a part of the UA Costock Colt. She's a very accomplished high school shooter, and we're looking forward to what she's going to be able to do going forward into the collegiate realm. She's going to be working, what is it, physical therapy? What?
PTA.
PTA. She's going to be working on a PTA degree, as well as growing and becoming a better shooter along the line, and we can't be more grateful for Ms. Aubrey. I met Ms. Aubrey 2 years ago at the Arkansas State High School shoot and started talking to her about our program and what we were doing then, and it's come a long way. Aubrey's come a long way as a shooter, and we're just really looking forward to where we're going to go from there.
Casa Tot Colts merchandise is now available at the ERCs in DeQueen, Ashdown, and Nashville. Come on in and let our friendly staff show you around. We have a lot to choose from, including t-shirts in a variety of styles and colors, caps, hoodies, polos, long sleeve t-shirts. We have joggers and stuff like coffee mugs and insulated thermal tumblers, as well as flash drives, lanyards, and power bank chargers. Just let the staff know what you need, and who knows, they might even model it for you. Show your Casa Tot school spirit. Get your Colts merchandise today at an ERC near you.
Good afternoon, and welcome to Lady Colts basketball here on ed88radio.com as we get set for a Saturday afternoon makeup game with ASU Mid-South. Lauren Hinton courtside, along with Timon Proby on the camera this afternoon. Anyway, we're a couple minutes away from the start of the ball game, and this, as I said, this is a makeup game because UA Casa Tot, our first time that we were supposed to go to ASU Mid-South, well, the weather got us, and then went over there, I guess, a week or so ago, and I'm guessing ASU Mid-South may have had a problem with having enough people on the roster that day. But anyway, this is a makeup game today, and these two teams will be right back at it again on the same court 1 week from today. So, anyway, it looks like we're about set for the national anthem, Barry.
Website, ed88radio.com, the sports page, also on the ed88 YouTube page.
Todd Bunn, your PA announcer, with our starting lineups tonight as we get set to get underway. Again, this is the first two times these teams have met this season due to, well, weather, illness, injury, whatever. Looks like we'll be back at it again 1 week from today as the Lady Greyhounds come in. They're looking for their first win of the season in conference play. They've lost seven in a row. This is not what we normally see from the Lady Greyhounds. They've won a couple of games this season. Both of them were on the road. They'll have their work cut out for them today, though, because Lady Colts are 9-3 at the house as the opening tip is controlled by the Lady Greyhounds. ASU Mid-South with the basketball. They'll bring it into the front court. They'll work it over on the right wing into the hands of Esther Kugala. Esther fires it inside. Spin move inside, and a traveling call is the call. Had the right idea. They tried to bring it inside, and looked like just simply getting her feet tangled up in there was London Robinson. Couldn't get the shot off. Lady Colts get it after the turnover. Samaya Smith up top. Sophomore guard out of Louisiana puts it in the corner. Hannah McClain fires up the three and knocks it down. Hannah McClain hits the three. McClain comes in averaging 13 points a ball game. Lady Colts take a 3-0 lead. Other end, shot put up by the Greyhounds. No good. Lady Colts have it. McClain gets it into the hands of Smith, and Smith will run it into the front court. Lady Colts work it left side. Three-pointer on the way by McClain. This one won't go. There's Smith with a rebound. Samaya fires it back out. Kiana Holly from beyond the arc. That one just barely catches the front of the rim, and the rebound is going to be pulled down by Robinson. London fires it ahead. Back in the hands of Quigala. They'll work it right side. That's Rutledge with it. Havana fires it inside. Now they get it back up top. Shot on the way off the back of the iron. Comes off no good. Rebound pulled down by Kiana Holly. Kugala shot no good. Smith has it, and she'll jog it into the front court. Lady Colts with a basketball. Tied for third place in the conference with a record of 3 wins, 3 conference losses. And they'll fire it inside to Reyes. And Sophia puts it up and in. Sophia averaging a dozen points per game. Lady Colts on top, 5-0. 8:20 to go, first quarter. That's Quigala with it. Outside the arc, gets it inside. Sophia Reyes tying up that basketball. Good defense that time by Reyes. And the possession arrow points to the Lady Colts. Lady Colts will have it. Greyhounds, only 6 players on that roster. Going to be imperative they stay out of foul trouble today. Lady Colts, last time out on this court, avenged an earlier season loss to North Arc. Playing some good basketball right about now. They get it on the perimeter, out to Holly. Holly tries to dribble around the defender. Good D that time of the Greyhounds. Bring it back left side. Holly gets it in the corner to Jared Cotton. Shot clock down to 6. Cotton needs to get, fires it underneath. Reyes on the, off the glass and good. No panic that time on the part of Cotton. I'm sitting there thinking, you got to get a shot off. Found a wide open Reyes underneath. Lady Colts on top, 7-0. Right side, 3-pointer, no good. Air ball, hauled down by Samaya Smith. Here come the Lady Colts into the front court. Jared Cotton fires it baseline to Cotton. Into Reyes. Reyes puts it up and in. Reyes with the basket. And the Lady Colts, with 6 points from Reyes, lead the Greyhounds by a score of 9-0. 7:05 to play, first quarter. Quigala with it. Gets it back up top. They'll fire it. Free throw line. Loose ball. Stolen away by Samaya Smith. Looks to go all the way with it. Lays it up and in. Samaya Smith with the basket. That's her first two, and we've got a timeout on the court. Our score, Lady Colts 11, Greyhounds nothing. We're back in a moment here on ed88radio.com.
Pilgrim's Pride Corporation is currently one of the largest chicken producers in the U.S. and delivers poultry products in more than 100 countries. Being a part of the family meal is a tremendous honor. They strive for great taste, flavor, and satisfaction in every Pilgrim's experience. People are at the heart of our business. Pilgrim's continues to focus on providing a safe and well-managed workplace that presents the best opportunity for our team members to thrive and have a better future. A big part of this community, right here at home, Pilgrim's Pride of DeQuinn.
Colts will have the basketball as we resume action here with 6:50 to play here in the first quarter. After that timeout, Lady Colts on top, 11-0. Greyhounds into the front court. Dugala gives it left side, back up top, into the hands of Cooper. Shot put up and in by the Greyhounds. Regala with the basket. That's her first two of the night. That coming with 6.5 minutes to play here in this first quarter. Shot underneath, no good. Put right back up and in by Hannah McLean. Jarrah Cotton gets the assist. McLean with the basket. She's got five. Lady Colts on top, 13-3. And we got a whistle out on the court. Personal foul is going to be called against the Lady Colts. That's going to be on Reyes. Reyes' first foul of the day. First team foul against the Lady Colts. First foul on anybody here in the early going with 6:05 to play here in this first quarter. Loose ball picked up by Kiana Holly in the backcourt. Bounce pass into the hands of Smith. Smith will jog it into the front court. Lady Colts work it left side. Out on the right wing, Kiana Holly wants that three-pointer and knocks it down. Holly buries the three. Kiana, her first points of the night. She comes in averaging 11 per game. Second three of the night for the Lady Colts. They lead it 16-3. Three-pointer left side, no good by the Greyhounds. Samaya Smith has the rebound. Needs some help. Gets it in the hands of McLean. Hannah gives it right back to Smith. Lady Colts on the attack. Right side, that's Holly. Is it back left side? Three-pointer on the way by McLean in there. Buries it. Hannah McLean with a three. She's got 8 points, her second three of the night. Lady Colts rolling to a 19-3 lead here in the early going. 5:10 to play here in this first quarter. On the perimeter. Shot. Ball comes into the hands of Reyes. Reyes gets it ahead to Smith. Smith over to McLean. Thought about the three. Instead goes to Jarrah Cotton. Goes baseline, drives underneath, kisses it off the glass and good. As Cotton has her first two, she averages 9 points per game. Lady Colts lead it 21-3. Quigala goes inside, lays it off the glass and good. And that's actually Robinson with the, that's Quigala with the basket there. She's got five. Lady Colts work it down court. Reyes, turnaround shot in the lane. Lost her footing. Went down. She's okay. The ball goes out of bounds. Apparently last touch by ASU Mid-South.
White ball. White ball.
Lady Colts have the basketball. They lead it 21-5. Inbounds pass to Reyes. Collision out there. I think Robinson just lost her footing. It's going to be called for the personal foul as she crashed into Reyes. It'll be the first personal foul, first team foul against the Greyhounds. Lady Colts will have it. Samaya Smith will trigger the inbounds pass with 4:23 to go here in this first quarter. Lady Colts looking to run that conference record of 4-3. Shot underneath by Reyes. Can't get it to go. And quickly coming the other way, driving through the lane. Splitting the defense, laying it up and in is Rutledge. Vanna Rutledge with a basket. Makes it 21-7. Lady Colts on top. 2:58 to play here in this first quarter. Up top, Kiana Holly for the three. Off the back of the iron, no good. And the rebound is going to be pulled down by Quigala. Esther gets it ahead. We'll get back right side into the hands of Kiana Parker, who just checked in a moment ago for the Greyhounds. Quigala goes inside, lays it up, can't get it to go. Rebound is going to be pulled on by Holly. Holly off to Smith, and Smith will bring the Lady Colts into the front court. They'll set the offense here. Looking for some motions, trying to set the play here. At the free throw line, that's Reyes. Gets it back left side. To McLean, tries to go inside, whistling a foul and a... Look at a little extra physicality there on the part of Kiana Parker. She's trying to prevent the McLean from getting inside. Looks like Reyes is going to check out of the lineup. And checking in her place will be Coriana Fulbright. Fulbright comes in, averaging 11 points per game. get it way out to Holly. Holly's all alone out there, puts it up and in. She gets on a roll. She's got her second three-pointer of the night as the Lady Greyhounds. Loose ball picked out of the air by Cotton. Good defense by the Lady Colts. Cotton fires it through the lane, underneath, laying it up and in, Fulbright. Third assist of the night by Jarrah Cotton. Fulbright with her first two, and the Lady Colts are rolling at 26-7. Steal, that's Cotton. Tries to go inside, and she is going to be hammered down low. Let's see, trying to figure out who that's on. And it looks like they're going to call this. Oh, it's going to be on Robinson. London Robinson called for a second personal foul. And the Lady Colts head to the free throw line. Jarrah Cotton to the charity stripe. She's got 2 points on the evening. First trip to the free throw line for either team tonight, as that one's on the way and it's good. Cotton has three. Lady Colts come in averaging about 70% from the free throw line. Second shot, it's good. And Cotton has 4 points now, and that Lady Colts lead is now 28-7. Greyhounds may have got away with a double dribble right there. Shot put up inside the lane and good. That was Rashara Cooper, that is. Has the ball stolen away. Greyhounds bring it the other way and laid it off the glass and good. That's Avanna Rutledge. She's got four. Lady Colts up by 17, 28-11. And let's see, Lady Colts will turn it over. Lady Colts led by as many as 21. Lady Greyhounds made a couple of baskets, and they have the basketball to try to cut in that lead a little bit farther. A lot of time to go here. A minute 58 to play here in this first quarter. Greyhounds working on the perimeter. Working back. Oh, good defense that time by Holly. Got it to McLean. McLean right back to Holly, and Holly comes across the horsey head to set the offense. Get it up front to Burns, who just checked in. Victoria gets it left side to Hannah McLean. Cotton looking inside to Fulbright. Fulbright working down low. Turnaround shot. Can't get it to go. Rebound comes off to the Greyhounds. They'll bring it quickly down court, try to drive inside. Instead, they'll go into the corner. And the Greyhounds will set the offense here. Pass tipped out of bounds. Last touch by the Lady Colts. I think Holly got a hand on it over there in the corner. So the Greyhounds will have it across the way. Trailing 28-11 with a minute 18 to play here in this first quarter. Out front with it, that's Parker. Kiana gets it back. Out to Rutledge. Back to Parker. Into the hands of Rester. Three-pointer up and in by Sherilyn Rester. Makes it 28-14. Mid-South on a 7-0 run as they steal it away again. Coming all the way, let's see. That's going to be a whistle and a foul on the court by Victoria Burns. Burns is going to be called for the personal foul as ASU Mid-South has scored seven straight, and they have the basketball underneath their own basket. Just under a minute to play, 50.3 seconds to go here in this first quarter. Greyhounds will try to get it in. They get it left side. Pull up, left side, free throw line elbow. Left elbow over there. That is a basket by Esther Quigala. Quigala has seven. Lady Colts lead down to a dozen. Out front, Cotton with it. She'll work it back left side to McLean. Looking underneath to Fulbright. Goes strong to the basket. She will be fouled by Rashara Cooper. Rashara Cooper called for the personal foul. That's her first. And Fulbright's going to head to the free throw line to shoot a couple. Fulbright's first trip to the free throw line tonight. Lady Colts 2-for-2 on the strength of Jarrah Cotton's made pair just a few moments ago. Fulbright has 2 points, make it 3 in the ball game, and that breaks that 9-point run by the Greyhounds. Fulbright's second shot, puts it up and in. Coriana now with 4 points in the ball game. Lady Colts up 30-16. 25 seconds remaining here in this first quarter. That's Rutledge. Gets it back left side. Up top to Cooper. Back over into the hands of Rutledge. Rutledge playing catch out there with Rester. Back to Rutledge, back to Rester. 7 seconds left in this first quarter. They're just trying to milk some time. Shot clock is off. Shot at the buzzer on the way in and out. No good. And we've come to the end of the first quarter of play. Our score, Lady Colts 30, ASU Mid-South 16. Back in a moment after this from Coca-Cola.
For those living together and those living apart. For classmates, graduates, and teachers making the best of it. For the restaurants delivering to our doorsteps. For the frontline workers putting it on the line every single day. For this great nation, determined to be stronger on the other side. Thanks to all of you, we'll be together again.
If you're ordering McDonald's and your friend says they don't want fries, get them the fries. Or else, your fries will be their fries. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
That's the score. Lady Colts lead it 30-16 over ASU Mid-South. Lady Colts basketball on NADARadio.com being brought to you by Pilgrims, by McDonald's of Southwest Arkansas, and by Coca-Cola of Nashville. Lady Colts scored the first 15 points of this ball game for ASU Mid-South. Put a point on the board. But then the ASU Mid-South, after Lady Colts went to up to a 21-point lead, ASU Mid-South scored 7 straight. And Lady Colts lead it by 14 after 1. Shot, left elbow, up and good. Pagala with the basket. She's got 9 points in the game. Lady Colts have the basketball up 30-18. Pass inside, looking for Fulbright. Pass stolen away by Rester. Pass a little hard, high a little hard that time. The pass, or the shot underneath is no good. Or actually from the corner, rebound is going to be picked up by Sierra Shaw. Shaw into the lineup, gets it ahead to Hernandez, or Burns rather. Burns trying to drive down. Hernandez is in the lineup as well. We set that lineup for you for the Lady Colts. It's Jira Cotton, along with Coriana Fulbright, Victoria Burns, Alexis Hernandez, and Sierra Shaw in the lineup for the Lady Colts. Pass into Shaw. Sierra puts it right up and in. Sierra's first 2 of the night. Lady Colts on top 32-18. ASU Mid-South with it, left side. Rutledge gets it free throw line, trying to drive down low. They'll pass it back out to Rutledge. Rutledge goes right side to Rester in the corner. Rester has it. Goes back right side to Quigala for 3. Her 3-pointer won't go. Fulbright trying to go for the rebound, and she's going to be fouled on the rebound attempt. Rutledge called for the personal. Lady Colts will have it. Up by 14, 32-18, with just under 9 minutes to play in the first half. We said Lady Colts 9-3 at home. 3-3 in conference play. Cotton looking inside, has that pass stolen away. Heads up defense that time by Quigala. They'll bring it the other way. Quigala drives it underneath, can't get it to go. Rebound comes off to Cotton. She'll get it ahead to Shaw. Sierra running into the front court. Right side, 3-pointer on the way. Off the glass and good. Victoria Burns. I don't know if she called glass on that shot or not. In a game of horse, she would have to. She knocked it down. 35-18, Lady Colts on top by 17. Shot put up by Rester won't go. Rester gets her own rebound, however. Fires it left side. Shot on the way by Rutledge is up and in and good. Actually, I said that was Rutledge. That was Rutledge, Havana Rutledge. She's got 6. Lady Colts have it back. Driving into the lane, Burns. The ball goes out of bounds. And looks like McLean's going to check in. Hannah's in for Jericho. So it's Lady Colts looking to get it in, trying to get it in the corner. Hernandez. Alexis spins it back out. Ball stolen away. Coming all the way with it. That's Rutledge. Lays it up. Can't get the layup to go. Mid-South has missed a couple of layups here in the second quarter. Down 35-20. Lady Colts have it. As Burns drives all the way, puts it high off the glass. Can't get it to go in the rebound. It's going to be pulled down by the Greyhounds. They get it up top. Three-pointer on the way by Rutledge. No good. Out of bounds. Lady Colts will have it on the far end. 7:19 to play here in this first half. Lady Colts on top, 35-20. Burns will bring it into the front court. Victoria gets past the defender. Back out to McLean. McLean drives through. Oh, has the ball stripped away. Loose ball picked up by the Greyhounds. They want to run. Rutledge goes all the way with it. Puts it up and in, and she's going to be fouled by Burns. Rutledge with the basket. She's got eight. Burns picks up the personal foul. That's her second. Ivana Rutledge at the free throw line. And Lady Colts getting three of their starters back in the lineup. Sophia Reyes checks in, as does Samaya Smith and Kiana Holly to join Hannah McLean and Victoria Burns, as the free throw is up and in by Ivana Rutledge. She's got nine. She ties Esther Quigala for high point honors with 9 points each. Lady Colts have it. They'll get it up top into the hands of Hernandez. Hernandez drives, puts a shot up off the glass, no good. Rebound tipped around, picked up by McLean, and she's going to be fouled on the shot. She'll go to the free throw line. Personal foul is going to be against Quigala. That's Quigala's first personal foul. McLean will head to the free throw line to shoot a couple. McLean's first trip to the free throw line tonight. Lady Colts as a team, 4-for-4 at the charity stripe. As we said, they don't look like the number 12 team in the country when it comes to free throw percentage. As McLean's first one is on the way and good. She's got 9 points in the ball game, leading all Colts scorers now. Looking for double figures right here. That one's no good, and the rebound comes off to the Lady Greyhounds. Greyhounds work it left wing. In the corner, back left side, pass into the backcourt, going to be picked up. Turnaround shot by Hernandez up and in. Alexis. Heads up move by Alexis. Quick release, got the shot to go. Lady Colts on top, 38-23. Driving inside, Robinson's going to be called for the charge. London called for the personal foul. That's her third. We said, Mid-South, with only six players on the roster, really can't afford to get anybody in foul trouble. And that third foul on Robinson coming with 6:11 to play here in this first half. Checking in her place will be Kiana Parker. Lady Colts have it. Up top, three-pointer on the way by Holly. Off the mark. Rebound is going to be pulled down by the Greyhounds. They want to run. Underneath, whistle foul. That's going to be on Holly. Was not going to give up the easy layup. So Holly picks up the first person, her first personal foul. Kiani. And heading to the free throw line will be Rester. Charlene Rester has 3 points in the ballgame. Her first trip to the free throw line. That one's off, no good. As a team, Mid-South, 1 out of 2 at the free throw line today. They trail at 38-23 with just under 6 minutes to play here in the first half. Second shot on the way, and it's good. Rester with four. Lady Colts have it. Samaya Smith will jog it into the front court. Gets it back right side. Holly has it out on the wing. Back out to Smith. Smith looking underneath. All alone under there. Reyes found an opening. Smith threaded the needle. Reyes gets the basket. She's got eight. Gives Smith another assist. She's had a couple of those in her career here at UA Cassatide. Quigala into the hands of Rester. Gets it over to Rutledge. Rutledge driving through. Left side back to Rutledge. Tries to make her way inside. Puts it up and in. Nice move on the basket that time by Ivana Rutledge. She's in double figures now with 11. Lady Colts on top by 14, 40-26. 5:05 to play here in this first half. Pass gets away, picked up by Rashara Cooper. Quigala. Gala with the basketball. She gets it over to Parker. Kiana into the hands of Rester. Sherilyn. Back over to Rester. Rester's three-pointer's up and in. They gave her some breathing room, and she nails it. Her second three of the night. Rester's got seven. Lady Colts on top by 11, 40-29. This is as close as ASU Mid-South has been in a while. Holly trying to make some room out there. Fires it, left side, looking for Hernandez, and the pass goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Lady Colts. Lygera Cotton's going to come in. Hernandez is coming out. It's the original starting five on the court right now for the Lady Colts. Smith, Holly, McLean, Cotton, and Reyes. Pagala at the free throw line. Gets it back left side to Rester. Out beyond the arc, fires it up and in. Rester with another three. She's got three of them. Lady Colts lead back to single digits at 40-32. 4:05 to go here in this first half, and the Lady Colts want a T.O. Timeout on the court. Colts 40, ASU Mid-South 32, 4:05 to play in this first half. We're back in a moment on N88Radio.com.
For your season of life, you'll find the financial products, digital tools, and friendly service that make you feel right at home with Farmers Bank. Come home to Farmers Bank.
Lead at 40-32 over ASU Mid-South. Lady Colts led by as many as 21. A lot of time to go in this one. Lady Colts will have it after the timeout. Smith will trigger the inbounds pass. Gets it into looking for Holly, but Holly was looking for it early. Turned her back, and the ball goes out of bounds. Lady Colts turn it over. Mid-South will have it across the way. Trailing by only 8, 40-32. This game had all the makings of a blowout earlier on, early in that first quarter when the Lady Colts were up by 21. Mid-South has clawed their way back within 8. Rutledge has it. Gets it out front to Quigala. Esther goes free throw line. Gets it just inside. Can't get the shot to go. Holly has the rebound, and she'll get it to Samaya Smith. Samaya works it right side. Kiana back over to Smith. Samaya gives it to Kiana Holly. She'll fire up the three. That one no good. Reyes is there for the rebound. Goes up strong. Can't get the rebound, the tip in to go, and the rebound comes off to ASU Mid-South. Coming the other way, that's Rutledge in traffic. Going to be a blocking foul against the Lady Colts. Personal foul is going to be called against Samaya Smith. For Samaya, that will be her first. Third team foul against the Lady Colts. Heading to the free throw line will be Rutledge. Havana tonight, 11 points in the ball game. One out of two now at the charity stripe as that one's off, no good. Havana will have another one coming. 3:25 to play here in this first half. Rutledge, second shot is good. Havana Rutledge now with a dozen points. And the Lady Greyhounds are within 7 at 40-33. Smith. Attacks inside the lane, can't get the one-hander to go, gets her own rebound, goes up strong, lays it off the glass, and good. Samaya Smith, she's got 4 in traffic. Lady Colts on top by 9, 42-33. Back right side, that's Rutledge with it. Ivana works it back left side, into the hands of Quigala. Esther out beyond the arc, they'll get it way out front. Rutledge will fire it up. That one no good. The rebound going sky high for the rebound is Hannah McLean. McLean played her high school basketball at Cossetal River. Big collision up top, no call. And the loose ball is going to be picked up by the Lady Greyhounds, bringing it all the way, laying it up, no good. That was Rester. Rester's going to be called for the personal foul. So Rester's calling for the personal foul. Sherilyn Rester, it's her first. And Sierra Shaw is going to come into the lineup for the Lady Colts. So it's McLean, Holly, Reyes, Cotton, and Shaw in the lineup. As Shaw came in place of Samaya Smith. At the charity stripe will be Sophia Reyes, points, 8 points in the ball game. Comes in averaging a dozen points per game for the Lady Colts. That shot's on the way, and it's in and out in. Finally. Kept us all in suspense there for a moment. Lady Colts now 7 out of 8 at the free throw line tonight. Reyes will have another one here. Lady Colts on top by 10, 43-33, regaining that double-digit lead. Is that second shot nice and smooth? It's in there. Count it. Lady Colts on top, 44-33, 11-point margin, and 10 points in the ballgame for Reyes. Rutledge has it. They'll work it back right side in the corner. Three-pointer on the way. Will not go, and the rebound tipped around. Fought for. Cotton gets it. Cotton has to separate the basketball from the Greyhounds. She'll get it ahead to Holly. Holly gets it over to Cotton. Cotton, head up. Look, always looking underneath. Bounce pass to Reyes at the free throw line. Dumps it underneath to McLean. Puts it up and in. McLean with a basket. Reyes with the assist. McLean, by the way, in double figures now with 10. Lady Colts on top, 46-33, with a minute 44 to play here in this first half. Three-pointer from the corner. Won't go. Rebound. McLean with another. Gets it in the hands of Holly. Holly gets it to Cotton. Cotton will pull up in the front court. Gets it over to McLean, attacks, lays it up, and let's see, is that a blocking foul or a charging foul? They're going to call that a charging foul on McLean. Hannah picks up her first personal foul. I said that was 10 points for McLean. McLean's actually got 11 points in the ballgame. Lady Colts on top, 46-33, with a minute 23 to play in this first half. Bounce pass up top. Actually, ball stripped, almost stripped away. Loose ball picked up by the Greyhounds. That one won't go. Rebound, Quigala with it. Gets it back up top into the hands of Rester. Rester back right side. Quigala outside the arc. Shot partially blocked by McLean. Picked out of the air by Holly. Kiana wants to run. Gets it up top. Jerry Cotton thought about the three. Gives it to McLean. She'll fire it up and in. Hannah McLean with a three. Hannah has hit three of them here in the first half. She's got 14. Lady Colts on top, 49-33, 40 seconds to play, first half. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Lady Colts will get another possession in this first half. At the free throw line, Greyhounds bring it back around. They'll give it to Rester. Ball almost tipped away. Rester puts it up at the free throw line, no good. Sierra Shaw with a rebound. Gets it ahead to Holly. They'll work it left side to McLean. Wants to take it underneath. She's going to be fouled. Stretching those long arms out. Drew the contact. Kiana Parker called for her second personal foul. And McLean's heading to the free throw line. Lady Colts on top. 49-33. 13 seconds remaining here in this first half. At the free throw line. Hannah McLean. She's 1 out of 2 at the free throw line today. Make it 1 out of 3. She'll have another one coming here. Maybe needs to back up. She's hit 3 three-pointers on the day. Only 1 out of 3 at the free throw line. Back up a little bit. Put that feet back behind that Pilgrims logo there. That shot's up and in. Hannah now with 15 points in the ball game. And looks like the Lady Colts will check in. Coriana Fulbright in the lineup. Lady Colts back on defense, up by 17, 50-33. 7 seconds left in this first half. Top of the key, Rutledge fires up the three, out of bounds. And there's 0.7 seconds left on that clock before now and intermission. As Holly gets it in to McLean, there's the buzzer. We've come to the end of the first half of play. Our score, Lady Colts 50. And the Lady Greyhounds 33. We're back to take a look at some halftime stats in a moment here on ed88radio.com.
Psst. Hey, Jake from State Farm. I want that personal price plan. So how's this for personal? I draw mustaches on players' faces when they're asleep.
Coach Reed, you don't need to get that personal to get the State Farm personal price plan. It helps you create an affordable price just for you.
Oh.
Coach, it happened again.
I'm gonna get to the bottom of this.
Call or click to get a quote today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
This live stream broadcast on Ed 88 is made possible by Satellite Service Company in Nashville, your authorized Dish Network dealer. Satellite Service Company and Dish Network serve the entertainment needs of the entire area. You like sports? Dish Network sports packages offer every sports fan exciting action featuring your favorite teams. The Dish Tailgater portable satellite TV antenna lets you watch TV wherever you are, at the lake, in the mountains, or at the tailgate party outside the stadium. The Dish Hopper gives you the power to transform your computer, smartphone, or tablet into your TV and enjoy your home TV anywhere. Special discounts and packages available to fit any budget. Satellite Service Company, 301 South Main Street in Nashville.
Look at where we are. Think of what we can do. What we're building together is special. And at Southwestern Electric Power Company, we know it's only the beginning. We can do more to improve our communities, our lives. We can reimagine how we use power and where that power comes from. We believe every person, no matter how unique, makes us stronger. By working together, the energy to accomplish our dreams is boundless.
South led by Sherilyn Rester. Sherilyn Rester with 15 points in the first half, including 4 3-pointers. 12 points in the first half for Ivana Rutledge, 9 for Esther Quigala, and 2 points for Rashara Cooper. Meanwhile, Lady Colts are led by Hannah McLean. She's got 15 points in the ball game, including 3 3-pointers in that first half. 10 points in the first half for Sophia Reyes. Looks like 6 points for Kiana Holly, all of those from beyond the arc. 4 points each for Jarrah Cotton and Samaya Smith. Meanwhile, Coriana Fulbright has 4 points in the ball game. 3 points in the first half for Victoria Burns, that from beyond the arc, and 2 points each for Alexis Hernandez and Sierra Shaw. Again, Lady Colts on top by a score of 50-33. We'll be back with more in a moment, as it's halftime here at the Bank of Locksburg Historic Gymnasium. Lady Colts on top, 50-33.
Joey Cassatot Physical Therapist Assistant and Occupational Therapy Assistant programs in Ashdown are designed to give our students the skills needed to be job ready in only 30 months. At UA Cassatot, our instructors are knowledgeable and experienced, our classes are affordable and small, and our facilities are big and well equipped. And you'll find our graduates on the job all over the Four States area. And that's something to celebrate. Application deadline is March 1st. UA Cassatot, your career starts here.
Migrated from Mexico to the United States when I was 6.5 years old. I think I turned 7 here. I still remember the day that I came in on a Friday. My dad had everything squared out. Like, he had it all planned out. We went to church that Sunday. It was all English. I had no idea what the priest was talking about. But because I'm Catholic, I know the routines and everything, so I was able to do some of that stuff. And then Monday, here we go to a school. In Mexico, I went to school with my siblings from 1 p.m. to 6 p.m. And then we walked to our school. We carried our little lunch bag, and then we come to a school where we have to get up early. I have to go in this big yellow bus, which I was afraid of. Not only that, but I get car sick, so you can imagine. I struggled for quite a bit. And then you come to a school where you can't communicate with your teachers, you can't communicate with your friends. At that time, the Hispanics that were at the week schools at that time were on the same boat that I was. We really couldn't help each other on the translating or interpreting because they were either just 1 year ahead of me at the school or just got in like me. So I do remember myself sleeping through the classroom. The only thing I knew to do was math, which I think that's universal numbers translate to all languages, I think. So I was able to do math. Other than that, I think I slept through the whole thing because poor teachers, they didn't know how to go about helping me or me communicating with them. So it was a struggle. It was very different, culture shocking. I learned that we get breakfast in the morning and then we get lunch and then we get to go home. So I wasn't used to that. I was used to carrying my own lunch, whatever I like. And now I'm having to eat this different food, different taste. And it was some difficult times. I could not mingle with my classmates as much because of the language barrier. Once again, we couldn't communicate. So I remember sitting myself back on a bench or somewhere in a corner, just watching everybody do their thing. And here I am crying because I was crying. I was separated from my siblings. They all went to different classrooms, different buildings. And then here I am by myself. And so I felt really, really bad. But in the long run, here I am. I'm a teacher now, and I'm in the ESL program position. So how I wanted to be a teacher, or how I got to this place, is I think to be somebody, you, in my opinion anyway, you are born with something. And in my situation, I feel I was born to be a teacher. Whether it was in Mexico or here or anywhere, I think I was born to be a teacher. I was born to help others. And since I was little and I can remember, everything and all I did was related to education. So I worked really, really hard in understanding the language. Once again, back in the day, there weren't a lot of resources for the Hispanic kids like me. I had to really learn a lot of stuff, and I don't think teachers, colleges knew exactly how to go about with students like me on helping them find what they needed. So I had to do a lot of research and asking around, and I don't think Googling at that time. I don't remember if we had Googled at that time. Probably did. I'm not that old though. But just the struggle to be where I'm at was not an easy path. But I have always said that easy is not always the best. If you struggled, you value more your struggle, your path. And I think I'm at that point. My path to where I'm at right now was not as easy, but I know it's not as hard as others. But thanks to all that, I am where I'm at. Thanks to my parents that brought me here. At that time, when I was 6.5 years old, I did not understand why I had to leave everything behind, family, home, everything, school, everything, and come to a place where I had no idea what it was about. To me, it was like moving from Earth to another planet. So I resented my parents for a good long 4 years, I think, because I felt they brought me without asking, without giving us a heads up of what's going to happen. Or if they did, I was so little, I do not remember. But now I thank them for what they did, because now at my hometown is probably not the best place to be right now because of all the stuff going around. But I feel safe in this country. I feel free, and I feel independent. All the struggles that I went through are worth it, because now I can value all that struggle and do what I want to do, which is to be a teacher, to work with kids, to work with the community. Now I am bilingual and I can use those skills to help others, kids, adults, whoever needs me. I'm there to help. So I value all of that stuff. And once again, how I got here, I think I always wanted to be a teacher and I worked hard for that. It wasn't easy, but if you have perseverance, if you work hard for what you want, you can always do it. So all you have to do is dream it, work for it, and then you can make it. Language barrier is not a problem, no more. If you make that as an excuse, I'm gonna say no, language barrier is not a problem. It's all in your head, it's all in your heart, is what you want for yourself. So if you want to succeed in life and you want to succeed in a good way, work hard, because things are not going to be placed in front of you and make it easy. They're going to be hard, and the hard path is always the best. The easy path, probably not.
Walk into the Coca-Cola facility in Nashville. You get a taste of Southwest Arkansas history from the past 100 years. The Wilson family bottled their very first Coke in Nashville back in 1911, and the rest is history. The office in Nashville offers an outstanding museum of Coca-Cola memorabilia, and it's open free to the public weekdays from 8 till 4. The Nashville Coca-Cola Distribution Center employs 20 people and serves several counties in Southwest Arkansas with a complete assortment of Coca-Cola and Dr. Pepper products. The Wilson family is known for their generosity in our community, and they're thankful to Southwest Arkansas for your support over the past century. And the Colts are thankful to Coca-Cola for everything they do for UA Cossatot.
Safety is a factor that shouldn't be overlooked when it comes to your car. Your vehicle needs safe engine parts or brake pads, but it also requires a reliable set of tires. Discount Tire and Alignment has a large selection of automotive tires that fit any car, truck, or SUV. They'll provide a safe and comfortable experience on the road, whether you're driving a short distance or for hours on the highway. It's smartness all around. Find everything from all season to specialty tires, oil changes, alignments, a clean facility, and friendly customer service. Discount Tire and Alignment, Highway 71 North in DeQueen, 870-642-5100.
South and the Lady Colts have gathered around their respective benches. Lady Colts break the huddle. And it's time for the second half. The Lady Colts will start the second half with their original starting five: Sophia Reyes, Kiana Holly, Hannah McClain, Samaya Smith, and Jera Cotton. Foul situation. Really, nobody in trouble for either team. Couple of personal fouls. I say that, and that is not true. London Robinson has three personal fouls for ASU Mid-South. Two on Kiana Parker. Nobody else with more than one. Lady Colts, only player with two is Victoria Burns, but everybody else either one or none as far as personal fouls are concerned. Mid-South will take the court right now. Lady Colts will have the basketball to start this second half, leading 50-33, and we are underway. Samaya Smith. The basketball at midcourt, gets it off to Jared Cotton. Cotton, bounce pass over to Hannah McClain. Back over to Cotton. Cotton to Smith. gets it into the hands of Cotton. Cotton right back to McLean, drives inside, taking the charge that time. Heads up defensive play on the part of Rutledge. Ivana Rutledge there to take the charge. Hannah McLean picks up the personal foul. It's her second personal foul. And Mid-South will have the basketball. Trailing 50-33, left side. Back up top to Rutledge. Rutledge to Rester. Rester takes a three, in and out, no good. And the rebound comes off the Lady Colts. That's McLean, gets it ahead to Samaya Smith. Smith back over to McLean, deep in the corner, Cotton. Cotton looking underneath to Reyes. Put it up a little too strong that time, and the rebound comes off to the Greyhounds. They want to run. Rutledge has it, gets it into the hands of Cooper. Deep in that right corner, that's Pagala. Puts it up and in. Her second three of the night. She's got a dozen points. ASU Mid-South draws first blood here in this second half. Lady Colts on top, 50-35. They're going to say that was only a two, I guess, all right? Lady Colts into the hands of Smith. Drives down, puts it up, can't get it to go, but the rebound, Reyes puts it high off the glass, no good. Rebound out of bounds, last touched by Mid-South. Smith will make the inbounds pass. And let's see. I think Reyes is going to come out. And Coriana Fulbright will check in. Smith, Holly, Fulbright, Cotton, McLean in the lineup for the Lady Colts. Smith needs to get it in. Lobs it into Fulbright. Works her way inside. Can't get it to go. Gets her own rebound. Puts it off the glass and good. Coriana Fulbright has 6 points in the ball game. Lady Colts get their first two of the second half, and they lead it 52-35. Pass, top of the key, in the hands of Cooper. Bashara works it back left side, going baseline, putting it up, no good. That was Robinson, or rather Quigala, who couldn't get the shot to go, and the rebound comes off the Lady Colts. Holly gets it up top to Samaya Smith. Back beyond the arc. Holly with the three-pointer, can't get it to go, and the rebound picked up by the Greyhounds on the run. That's Rester. Sherilyn way out front. Quigala. Quigala goes inside. Big collision underneath, no call. And putting the shot up and in's Robinson. London gets her first two of the night. 52-37. Lady Colts on top by 15. That's McLean into the hands of Smith. Smith works it way out front to Holly. And she will be fouled, a reaching foul, going to be called against Rester. Charlin called for her first personal, that's her second personal foul, excuse me. She had 15 points in that first half. As Lady Colts will put it in play on the baseline. Actually, right here in front of the Lady Colts bench is Smith with it. In the corner to McLean, underneath Cotton, working through the lane. Tries to go all the way around, ball goes out of bounds, tipped out of bounds by Mid-South. Lady Colts will have it underneath their own basket. Leading 52-37, 6:49 to go in this third quarter. And a pass tipped out of bounds. Last touched by Mid-South. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Pass into Cotton. That ball did everything but go in. Fought for it, got it. And loose ball picked up by Cotton. Gets it over to Fulbright. Fulbright gets the basket. Cotton gets the assist lying on her back. Lying down on the job. Backing that basketball back out is Rutledge. She gets it to Cooper, over to Rester. Rester dangerous from three-point land. She had 5 three-pointers in that first half. Four three-pointers in that first half as Cotton steals it away to Fulbright. Gets it off to Holly, right side. Smith, cross court, in the hands of Cotton. Down low to Fulbright. Had her dribble tipped away. Loose ball picked up by Mid-South. On the attack, that's Rutledge. Drives inside the lane, collision inside. That's going to be on Holly. Kiana, or actually, that is a charging foul. Let me call that on Rutledge. As apparently, Holly was set. Took the charge. Lady Colts get it back on top, 54-37. Just under 6 minutes to play here in this third quarter. Left side, that's Cotton. Out front to McLean. Back to Cotton. Lob underneath to Fulbright. Gets it, catches up with it. Gets it to Smith in the corner for three. That one caught the side of the backboard. Mid-South, a one-on-two. Rester's going to have to back it out. Gets it to Quigala. Attacks. One-hander, no good. Rebound. Smith. Smile with some pressure in the backcourt. Runs it into the front court. Is it left side to McLean? Fake the three. Drove down low, drew the foul. She's going to the free throw line. Personal foul is going to be called against London Robinson. That's her fourth personal foul. At the free throw line will be Hannah McLean. McLean on the day. Two out of four at the free throw line. 15 points in that first half. Her first trip to the free throw line in the second half. Shots on the way, and it is good. Hannah with 16 points in the ball game. Lady Colts on top, 55-37. 5:20 to go in this third quarter. Second shot's on the way, and it is good. McLean with 17. Lady Colts on top by 19, 56-37. Rester to Quigala, and a pass almost stolen away by Jera Cotton. Rester back up top to Cooper to Rester for three. No good. Rebound picked up by the Greyhounds. Quigala inside. They work it left side the corner. Rester's three-pointer won't go. Actually, that was Rutledge's three-point. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Mid-South. The Lady Colts get it back. Just under 5 minutes to go here in this third quarter. In the hands of Cotton at the free throw line. Gets it to McLean. McLean gets it right back out to Holly, to Cotton, right side. They're going to leave McLean alone from about 14 feet. That shot won't go. There's Fulbright with a rebound. Fought for it inside. Gets it to McLean, and McLean's going to be fouled. That's going to be on Rester. Rester got her feet tangled up with McLean underneath. That's her third personal foul. Only six players on the roster today for ASU Mid-South. Two of them are in foul trouble. Robinson's on the bench with four. Rutledge on the court with three. Underneath, McLean, double dribble. The ball goes right back over to ASU Mid-South. They trail it 56-37, 4:26 to play in the third quarter. Mid-South at the free throw line. They'll work it back in that corner, right side. Three-pointer, no good. Cooper chases down the rebound. Good hustle that time. Rutledge has it, gets it in the hands of Quigala. Esther fires it up, 16-footer good. Quigala now with 14 points in the ball game. Lady Colts with the basketball. Lead at 17, 56-39. Just under 4 minutes to play in this third quarter. Smith, oh, nice give underneath. Fulbright takes it the hole. Can't get it to go down, though, but she will be fouled. And we'll see who that's on. That's going to be on Cooper. Rashara called for her second personal foul. That's going to send to the free throw line. Coriana Fulbright. Fulbright 2 for 2 on the day at the free throw line. She got 8 points in the ball game, looking for double figures on this trip. 3:45 to go in this third quarter. Lady Colts on top, 56-39. Fulbright comes in the ball game, averaging 11 points a game. She's still stuck at 8 right now. She'll have another one coming here. Fulbright, second shot is good. Fulbright with 9. Lady Colts on top by 18, 57-39. 3:45 to go, third quarter. Quigala into the hands of Rester. Left side, Rutledge will fire it up and nails it. Rester can absolutely nail it, huh? Charlene Rester with 18. Five of them from three-point land. Pass underneath. driving it all the way. That's Fulbright, puts it up and in. Coriana now in double figures with 11. Lady Colts lead it 59-42. They led by 17 at the half, and they maintain that 17-point lead. Driving through, that's Cooper. Her shot no good. Tried to get the rebound out of bounds off the Lady Colts. I think McLean may have had a hand on it over there. Cooper stayed with the play. Mid-South will have it underneath their own basket. 3:03 to play, third quarter. Left side. That's Quigala. Esther backs it back out. Fires it up from inside the three-point arc. It's up and good. Quigala now with 7 points here in the second half. She's got 16 in the ball game. Mid-South throws it away into the back. Actually, they stole it away, and the ball out of bounds. Last touch by Mid-South. They had the right idea, just couldn't catch up with it on the break. Victoria Burns in the lineup for the Lady Colts, joining Fulbright, McLean, Cotton, and Holly underneath. Let's see here. Whistle underneath. And they're going to say the personal foul is going to be on Cooper. Rashara Cooper now with her third personal foul. So three of Mid-South's six players are in foul trouble right now. McLean will be at the free throw line to shoot a pair. Lady Colts at the free throw line today. As McLean's first one's up and in. Lady Colts now 12 out of 16. Both of those are good. Had to add it up here in a minute. Trying to do math on the run was never my forte. Here we go. Mid-South with it on the perimeter. In the hands of Cooper. Finds Quigala on the baseline. Ball stripped away, picked up by Cotton. Gets it ahead to Holly. Kiana fires it ahead to McLean on the run. Gets it back out to Cotton. Cotton drives into the lane. Gets it back over to Holly for three. Nails it. He knew that was good the minute it left her hand. Kiana Holly with a three. She's got three of them today. She's got 9 points in the ballgame. The Lady Colts steal it away. Fulbright to Burns. And then Victoria has her pocket pick. Coming the other way, that's Quigala. Lays it up, no good. There's Holly with a rebound. Lady Colts will run it the other way. Holly's three, won't go. Rebound, Fulbright gets it, puts it up and in. Makes it look easy down there. Fulbright with 9 points in the second half. She's got 13 in the ballgame. Lady Colts had their biggest lead of the night at 66-22. I say 66-44. That's a 22-point lead. Get it right here. Underneath, Quigala, shot no good. Gets her own rebound. They'll fire it back out. Three-pointer on the way. And that is Rutledge with the basket. Rutledge with 15 points in the ball game. Lady Colts have it as Burns drives. Runner from 12 feet won't go. I think one of the Greyhounds got a hand on it. As Holly's three-pointer no good. McLean in there to try to get the rebound, has it slapped out of bounds. I believe it went off the fingertips of Kiana Parker. Lady Colts will have it underneath their own basket. Just under a minute to play in this third quarter. Pass left wing to Holly. Holly around the screen by McLean, drives through the lane. It's going to be called for the travel. Defense that time by Quigala. Got just in front of the drive, caused a turnover. Sierra Shaw is going to come in the lineup along with Alexis Hernandez. Jerry Cotton's going to come out of the lineup. Let's see, it looks like it's going to be Burns, Shaw, Hernandez, Fulbright, and McLean in the lineup for the Lady Colts. Mid-South will pick it up at the midcourt stripe. 45 seconds remaining in this third quarter. Rutledge, long three-pointer by Rutledge. No good, rebound picked up by McLean. Hannah gets it ahead to Burns. Burns right side. Shaw gives it to Burns. Burns spins. In the corner it goes to Shaw. In and out and in and out. And the rebound's picked up by McLean. High off the glass, no good. Rebound, Shaw gets it, puts it up and in. Only fitting that Shaw gets the basket. Lady Colts worked hard for that one. Shaw with 4 points in the ball game. Mid-South with it with 10 seconds to go in this third quarter. Down 68-47. Mid-South on the perimeter. 2 seconds. As Rester fires up the three in there at the buzzer. Rester knocks down another three. It's been a long day for the Lady Greyhounds, but Rester has 6 3-pointers in this ball game. They've got a timeout for the intermission in between the third and fourth quarter. We'll be back in a moment. Lady Colts on top, 68-50 here on NADARadio.com.
For your season of life, you'll find the financial products, digital tools, and friendly service that make you feel right at home with Farmers Bank. Come home to Farmers Bank.
Record to 10-3. Mid-South, free throw line. That's Cooper, gets it out on the corner, on the right wing, that is, to Quigala. To Rester in the corner, double team over there. Lady Colts tip it out of bounds. 14 seconds on the shot clock as the Greyhounds will put it in play in the far corner, trailing 68-50. Pass up top to Rutledge. Out it goes to Rester, left side. Three-pointer on the way. Open three won't go. Shot put up by Parker, and the rebound comes off Lady Colts. Coming the other way with it. That's McLean. Layup won't go. Rebound comes off to Mid-South. They want to run. They'll take it all away. Rester, or is that Rutledge? Going to be taken to the hole, but she will be fouled. The personal foul. Sierra Shaw called for the personal foul. That's her first. And heading to the free throw line to shoot a couple will be Ivana Rutledge. So it looks like Robinson's going to check back in. London Robinson on the court right now with 4 personal fouls. By the way, Rutledge has picked up. Rutledge has 3. Rashara Cooper has 3. 51-68. 68-51, I should say. Lady Colts on top. Shot no good by Ivana Rutledge. Lady Colts have it. Backing it out. Shaw, oh, nice steal that time on the part of Rutledge. Wants to go the other way with it. McLean trying to block it, but Rutledge found a way to scoop it up and in. She's got 17 points in this ball game right now. And a ball stolen away by Mid-South. Personal foul is going to be called on Hannah McLean. That's her third. Mid-South will have it on the far side. Left wing, that's Rutledge. Gets it back up top to McCullough. Shot no good. Rebound. That's McLean. Hannah into the front court. Right side it goes. Three-pointer on the way by Shaw. Can't get that one to go in the rebound. On the run, Mid-South. They've got somebody open down court, taking it all the way, laying it up and in. That's Robinson. London has 4 points now. And the Lady Colts going to send in some fresh faces out there. As McLean drives into the lane, lays it up, can't get it go, gets her own rebound, no good. And went up again, and a jump ball is a call. Possession era points to Mid-South. Lady Colts will make some substitutions right here, right? Actually, I guess the possession era points to Lady Colts. So Lady Colts will have it here. Smith in the lineup, makes the inbound pass, nobody home. Taking it all away, that's Quigala, lays it up, no good, rebound, comes off to Cotton. See if Cotton's okay. She came down on her back, bumped her head, let's see. She wants up. She's up. And a personal foul is going to be called against Mid-South. And I have to judge by the reaction, that must have been on number 5. Let's see. Still the way the officials are talking it over right here. It is on number 5. Technical foul. That'll be her 4th on Cooper. We got a full timeout on the court, so we'll sort it out and be back with more in a moment here on N88 Radio.
I lost my mind in the city of light, and the bad street burns in the neon lights. When I heard the thunder, I could feel the rain. It's the same to me, just a different name. Won't you follow me in the jungle? Ain't no God for my streets in the heart of the jungle. Won't you follow me into the jungle.
Well, Hannah McLean will head to the free throw line to shoot that technical foul. Shots on the way, and Hannah misses the front end of that opportunity there. She made 4 in a row. Actually, 5 in a row prior to that one. Second shot's on the way. Starting a brand new streak here. If she knocks that one down, she's got 20 points in the ballgame for the Lady Colts. So right now, foul situation. It's Rashara Cooper and London Robinson, each with 4 for Mid-South. Ivana Rutledge with 3. Holly has it up top to Smith. Lady Colts run a little weave up top. 8 minutes to go in the ballgame. Lady Colts underneath looking for Reyes. Couldn't quite reel that one in. Just under 8 minutes to play in the game. Lady Colts on top by 14, 69-55. Mid-South, back in mid-January, they had 3 games where they played some really close contests. But as I say, they've only had 2 wins on the season. Both of those were on the road. 3-pointer on the way by Rester, won't go. And a rebound comes off to Holly. Holly to Smith, Samaya, left side. They get it to Cotton in the left corner. Goes baseline all alone down there, lays it off the glass and good. Well, Cotton saw exactly what she was looking for down there. A little bit of room, that's all she needed. She gets 6 points in the ball game. 71-55, Lady Colts on top, 7:15 to go in the game. Rutledge has it, works through the perimeter, collision underneath. Picked up, shot put up and in by Robinson. Robinson with 6 points, all of them here in the second half. Lady Colts lead at 71-57. Loose ball on the court, picked up by the Lady Colts. Over to Holly, she'll take the 3, in there! Sweet spot, Kiana Holly. She's got a dozen, all of them from beyond the arc. And we got a timeout by ASU Mid-South. 6:50 to go in the ball game. Lady Colts on top, 74-57.
It is time for the final question. Who is offered the Rogers rate? Jacob State Farm? Basically anyone. Sorry, buddy, that's incorrect.
See? We offer great rates that fit anyone's budget.
That's enough. Thank you very much. Jessica in the middle. You said me? No. What are you doing? Whatever. Also me. Great LOL. That was really important. Of course. Everybody gets the rates, I guess.
For a surprisingly great rates that fit any budget, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Call or click to get a quote today.
Your local State Farm insurance agent in DeQueen is Luke Billingsley, 870-642-2157.
Lady Colts lead at 74-57, under 7 minutes to play in the ball game. Mid-South will have the basketball after that timeout. Lady Colts have Sophia Reyes, along with Samaya Smith, Kiana Holly, Jerry Cotton, and Hannah McLean in the lineup, their starting lineup today. Loose ball tipped away by Cotton. She'll pick it up, and the Lady Colts bring it the other way. Smith thought about pulling up for the three. Instead, goes baseline to Reyes, gives it right back to McLean. Underneath the Cotton, lays it up, can't get it to go. The rebound out of bounds, last touch by Mid-South. Lady Colts got the shot they wanted. And let's see here. Looks like Cooper's going to check out of the lineup. Checking in will be Kiana Parker. Smith will make the inbounds pass. Gets it into Kiana Holly. Her shot no good. And the rebound chased down by Rutledge. Ivana across the midcourt stripe. Gets it over to Quigala. In the hands of Robinson. Her shot no good. And the ball's tied up on the rebound attempt by Jerry Cotton. Possession arrow points to Mid-South. Greyhounds will have it underneath their own basket, trailing 74-57 with 6:04 to go in the ballgame. Mid-South, inbounds pass, right side. Shot put up by Robinson, no good. Smith gets a rebound. Lady Colts point guard on the attack. Facing some pressure out there from Rutledge. They'll get it at the free throw line to Reyes. Kicks it back out to Holly for three, nails it. Kiana Holly with 5 3-pointers in the ball game. 15 points for Holly. Lady Colts on top by 20. 77-57. Quigala has it. Out by the NJCAA emblem on the right side. In the corner it goes. Rutledge says, I'll fire it up. Couldn't get it to go, though, and the rebound comes down to Lady Colts. Over to Holly for another three. That one off the back of the iron picked up by Robinson. Gets it ahead to Rutledge. Ivana drives, tries to get around Kiana Holly. And Holly going to be called for the personal foul. Got a hip in there. Kiana Holly called for the personal foul. That's only her second. Head to the free throw line will be Ivana Rutledge. Rutledge came in averaging 14 points a game, and she's got 18 today. Shot's on the way. It's up and good. Rutledge on the day, 4 out of 6 at the free throw line. She'll have another one coming here, 77-58. Lady Colts on top by 18 now as that second shot's up and in. And the inbounds pass, right back to McLean. She'll jog it into the front court. Working against Parker, lays it high off the glass, no good. Reyes had it momentarily, and Mid-South brings it the other way quickly. Lady Colts get it right back, though. Kiana Holly stealing it away from Rutledge. Gets it to Smith. Smith fires it out to McLean for a long three off the back of the iron. Thought that one was going down. Mid-South gets it back. Trailing 77-59. 4:40 to go in the contest. In the corner. Parker fires it over to Quigala. And the Lady Colts bring it the other way. Yes, personal foul is going to be on Quigala. That's her second. And at the free throw line for the Lady Colts will be Samaya Smith. Smith on the day, 4 points in the ball game. Hasn't been to the free. This will be her first trip to the free throw line today. Colts 7 of 9 at the free throw line the second half, 14 out of 17 on the day. Smith is ready for her second one. Sends it on the way, and it's good. Smith and the Lady Colts lead it now by a score of 79-59 with 4:25 to go in the game. Had some folks from Mid-South drive down for the ball game. That's a devoted fan right now because that is a long, long, long drive to make. As the Lady Colts come out of there with the rebound, they had the rebound, but a whistle on the baseline. And apparently Smith may have been on the, actually, Smith was on the baseline with the ball, and the ball goes right back over to Mid-South. Samaya fighting for that loose basketball. Mid-South trying to make the inbounds pass. They do to Cooper in the lane, puts it right up and in. Rashara found herself all alone under there. She's got 4 points in the game. Lady Colts up by 18. Jarrah Cotton goes around the defender, gets underneath, fires it back out to Kiana Holly. Her shot is blocked by Rutledge, and the ball saved inbounds. Good job by Rester, gets it off to Rutledge. Good hustle that time. Down by 18, Mid-South. Kept that ball alive. Rutledge got the basket. Good job by Rester to get it right back to her. Lady Colts, Jarrah Cotton inside the lane, working. Gets it right back out to Holly. Goes around the defender, goes baseline, scoops it off the glass and good. Holly with 17 points in the ball game, 81-63. Lady Colts on top, 3:15 to go in the game. Ball stolen away, tied up and stolen away by Jarrah Cotton. And I say stolen away because on the jump ball, the Lady Colts have it as a possession arrow is pointing in their direction. Down to 3:11 to go in this game. Smith works it underneath to Reyes, has the ball almost stripped away, and a jump ball is a call, and the possession arrow points to Mid-South. Reyes looking to take a dribble and get a little closer. Got that ball tied up down there. Lady Colts turn it over. 3:03 to go in the game. Up by 18. 81-63. Mid-South will run it into the front court. That's Quigala. Gets it over to Rester. Back over to Esther Quigala. Her shot on the baseline up and in. Esther Quigala, 9 in the first half, 9 in the second, 18 in the ball game. Pass over to Cotton. Cotton fires it right side to Holly. She'll step back, take the three, can't get it to go. Rebound, Cotton. Good hustle that time by Jarrah. Loose ball on the court. Jump ball's a call. Possession arrow points the Lady Colts. 2.5 minutes to go in this one. Lady Colts on top by 16, 81-65. Led by as many as 22 on the day. Lady Colts will make the inbounds pass underneath. Shot laid up and in by Jarrah Cotton. Excuse me, that's Hannah McLean. Hannah McLean with the basket. McLean now with 24 points in the ball game. And here come the Lady Colts. Holly works it left side. McLean will take the long three-pointer. Won't go. Rebound. There's Samaya Smith. Kisses it off the glass and good. Smith now with 8 points in the ball game. 85-65. Lady Colts on top by 20. Rester gets it out to Rutledge. Oh, nice give underneath. All alone underneath. That's Robinson. She's got 8 points in the ball game. All of them here in the second half. Lady Colts up by 18. The ball stolen away by Rutledge. Ivana goes all the way, puts it up and in. Rutledge having a big night. She had 12 points in the first half, 12 in the second. 24 points in this ball game. There we go. Cotton backs it out. 13 on the shot clock to Smith. They'll set the offense right here. Looking to find somebody getting open underneath. They'll give it to McLean. Turnaround shot by McLean in there. Give Smith the assist. McLean with another basket. Lady Colts lead it 87-69. 1:05 to play. Shot put up and in. The Lady Colts have it back. Bounce pass right side. Reyes thought about it. 1 minute to play in the game. Lady Colts looking to move to 4-3 in the conference as Reyes puts it off the glass and good. Sophia Reyes, her first two of the second half. She's got a dozen in the ball game.
Three-pointer run away by Quigala, won't go. Rebound. Comes off to McLean. 40 seconds to go in this game. Smith up top, working around the double team. She will be fouled. Reaching foul going to be called on Rutledge. Ivana called for her fourth personal foul. She, along with Rashara Cooper and London Robinson, each with four personal fouls, and Lady Colts will have it on the side. On top, 89-71, 33.8 to play in the game. Looking for McLean to get open. McLean got caught in traffic, tipped the ball away. Reyes got it, put it off the glass and good. Talk about making lemonade out of a lemon. That'll work. 23 seconds to go. Lady Colts on top, 91-71. Quigala out front. They'll get it in the hands of Rester. Rester has hit six threes already on the day. That one's no good. And the rebound comes off Lady Colts. Holly gets it over to Smith. Shot clock is off, down to 3 seconds. And Cotton lays it off the glass and good. And that'll do it. Final score. Lady Colts win it, 93-71. We'll be back to wrap this one up in a moment here on Ed88Radio.com.
Wade Cossetot is launching a brand new aerial lineman training course. This 145-hour clock hour course will offer training in broadband essentials and aerial lineman communications, with graduates receiving a career training work-ready certificate. The median yearly income for a communications aerial lineman in America is over $60,000. And the industry will need an average of 10,000 new linemen each year for the next 10 years. The UAC Aerial Lineman course will have you job ready in just 4 weeks. And qualifying participants pay zero tuition. We have the trucks, we have the poles, we have the equipment and the classroom. All we need is you. To find out more, check us out online at www.cccua.edu or call 870-584-1178 or email continuingeducation@cccua.edu. Come train at the college that bestcolleges.com ranks as the number one community college in the state, University of Arkansas, Cossetot. Wade Cossetot Physical Therapist Assistant and Occupational Therapy Assistant programs in Ashdown are designed to give our students the skills needed to be job ready in only 30 months. At UA Cossetot, our instructors are knowledgeable and experienced. Our classes are affordable and small, and our facilities are big and well equipped. And you'll find our graduates on the job all over the four states area. And that's something to celebrate. Application deadline is March 1st. UA Cossetot, your career starts here.
Final score today, Lady Colts win at 93-71 to run their conference record to 4-3 on the season. They came in tied with North Ark for third place in the conference. And anyway, of course, SAU Tech at the top of the standings, 8-0, and just a fantastic basketball team. ASU Mid-South found themselves down by 21 points early on in that first half, but battled back, cut the lead down to 7, and never gave up. Credit their effort today, as they were led today by Ivana Rutledge with 24 points, 21 points today for Charlene Rester, including 6 3-pointers on the day. Also, in the scoring column today was Esther Quigala with 18 points, as the ASU Mid-South now falls back to 2-18, I believe. Lady Colts, on the other hand, another good performance here at home as they pick up their 10th home win on the season, 10-3 at home, and the Lady Colts were led today by 24 points from Hannah McLean. She had, 3 3-pointers in that first half, 24 points for Hannah McLean, 17 points today for Kiana Holly, all but
14 points today for Sophia Reyes, 13 points for Coriana Fulbright. Looks like 8 points in the ball game today for both Samaya Smith and Jarrah Cotton. 3 points on the day for Victoria Burns, 2 points for Alexis Hernandez. And also figuring in the scoring column today was Sierra Shaw. She finished the day with 4 points. Again, Lady Colts win it by a final score of 93-71. And their next time out will be Monday night, as Lady Colts and the Colts will be at home here in the Bank Lockford Historic Gymnasium. We'll be taking on South Arc. And anyway, the ladies will tip it off at 5:30. The men